Hi, this is Dr. Bay, and here's Bugsy. And today we're going to talk about alcohol displacement reactions and synthetic strategies. So stay tuned.
Organic chemistry
taught by Dr. Bay.
Reaction mechanisms,
reactants to products,
retrosynthesis,
target deconstructing,
molecules, spectroscopy, soaring through the sky, triumphantly fly. Give rise to the complexity of life, living on a dream across the seven seas, learning about spectroscopy.
So you learned about various different reagents that can take you from a carbonyl, such as a ketone or aldehyde, to an alcohol, to an alkyl halide, and vice versa. To go from a carbonyl to an alcohol, you can use a reducing reagent, such as lithium aluminum hydride or sodium hydride. But to go in the reverse, from alcohol to carbonyl, you can use an oxidizing reagent, like Jones reagent, PCC, DMP, or perform even a Swern oxidation. Now, if we look at the other half of this, to go from an alkyl halide to an alcohol, you can use NaOH to undergo an SN2 reaction, or you could even use water to undergo an SN1 reaction. But what about going in the reverse? To turn an alcohol, which is a bad leaving group, into an alkyl halide, which is a good leaving group, we can use an alcohol displacement reaction. The first alcohol displacement reaction uses HBr. In this example, a primary alcohol reacts with HBr to form a primary alkyl bromide. The mechanism starts with one of the lone pairs of O grabbing the hydrogen in HBr and the HBr bond breaking to form a new lone pair on bromine. Then Br- attacks the alpha carbon, and water, which is now a good leaving group, breaks off to form your product. The second way to displace an alcohol is to use tosyl chloride and pyridine. The mechanism starts with one of the lone pairs of O attacking the sulfur atom of a tosyl group. Then another arrow from the sulfur chloride bond breaks to form a lone pair on Cl. Then pyridine acts as a base to deprotonate the extra hydrogen, leaving us with an O-tos product. Keep in mind that the stereochemistry of the hydroxyl group stays the same. In this example, the hydroxyl group in the starting reagent is on a dashed bond, and the O-tos group in the product is still on a dashed bond. Another way to convert primary and secondary alcohols into an alkyl halide is to use an inorganic acid via an SN2 process. One way is to use PX3, where X could be any halogen like bromine, iodine, or chlorine. The mechanism of this example starts with one of the lone pairs of O attacking the phosphorus atom of PCl3. Then, one of the chlorides breaks off to form the following intermediate. Then, the Cl- that broke off comes back and attacks the alpha carbon, and the entire leaving group leaves. Since this is an SN2 process and the current leaving group was on a wedged bond, Cl- will attach as a dashed bond due to inversion of stereochemistry. Another type of inorganic acid is thionyl chloride, or SOCl2. The mechanism starts from one of the lone pairs of O attacking the sulfur atom, and then the SO double bond breaks to form a lone pair on oxygen. Then the lone pair on O- comes back down to reform the pi bond, and one of the Cl atoms leaves. Pyridine then comes in and acts as a base to deprotonate the hydrogen atom to then form a new lone pair on O. And then Cl- comes back and attacks the alpha carbon, which then forms our final product where the Cl group is on the opposite bond type again due to inversion of stereochemistry. Now we can fill in this schematic with the four types of alcohol displacement reactions to go from an alcohol, which is a bad leaving group, into an alkyl halide, a good leaving group. And we can even expand this to show even more interconversions between functional groups that you previously learned about. Knowing how all of these reactions connect with one another will be extremely useful when doing synthesis problems. So let's do a refresher. To reduce an alkyne to an alkene, you can use H2 with Lindler's catalyst to form a cis alkene, or you could use Birch reduction with Na and NH3 to form a transalkene. Then to reduce an alkene into an alkane, you can use catalytic hydrogenation with H2 and a metal catalyst like platinum, palladium, or nickel. To oxidize an alkene into an alkyne, it is a three-step process where first you undergo bromination with a polar aprotic solvent, then second, use NaNH2 in excess, and third, use water to then form the alkyne. To go from an alkyne to a ketone, you can use oxymercuration demercuration, or to go from an alkyne to an aldehyde, you can use hydroboration oxidation. To go from an alcohol to an alkene, you can undergo either an E1 or an E2 reaction. In the reverse fashion, you can go from an alkene to an alcohol by undergoing either an acid-catalyzed hydration, hydroboration oxidation, or oxymercuration demercuration. To go from an alkene to an alkyl halide, you can use either HX that follows Markovnikov's rule, or HBr with a peroxide that then follows anti-Markovnikov's rule. And then in the reverse, to go from an alkyl halide to an alkene, an elimination reaction could be used. And lastly, to go from an alkane to an alkyl halide, you could use radical halogenation with light. Keep in mind that this is just a generalized map and that there could be any number of carbons connected to each of these functional groups.